You can change your clothes, but when it comes to your skin, you're kind of stuck with the genetic hand that you were dealt. For me, that meant moderate teenage acne and even mild acne into my adult years in my 20s and 30s. I gotta tell you, it's kind of a letdown when your acne sticks around as you get older. I'd already kind of internalized the fact that I wasn't gonna get any taller, but really, acne in my 20s and 30s? These days though, my skin actually looks better than it ever has. It's not perfect, you know, you have certain genetic limitations. I'll never have flawless skin with tiny invisible pores, but it does look better than it ever has. And it's really just been a lot of trial and error with an emphasis on the error. And that's why I'm making this video. I want to help you avoid some of these same pitfalls. Before we get into it, quick thank you to today's sponsor, Geology. Geology is a simple skincare routine formulated for daily use. It works for guys who don't have any sort of skincare routine or seasoned experts who just want an upgrade. Unlike anything you'll find in the store, Geology is personalized for your skin type. So if you have sensitive skin or if you need to manage adult acne, Geology can help. Here's how it works. You take a 30-second diagnostic quiz and Geology formulates a regimen that provides the benefits you need, such as oil control or reduced wrinkles. Then you start a 30-day trial set that includes an everyday face wash, morning face cream, repairing night cream, and an eye cream. And actually they include two bottles of the face wash, one for your shower and one for the sink or your gym bag or dop kit. Once you're happy with your regimen, you can continue with a 90-day supply, either by subscribing or buying a la carte. So the choice is yours and you're not locked into anything. I actually first tried Geology back in May 2019 and I was really impressed with the ingredients that were included in my regimen. For example, my face wash had salicylic acid, which is used to fight acne. The morning face cream has SPF built in, which is a must-have for me. And the night cream has retinol, which is an anti-aging ingredient that I know works well for my skin. Put simply, Geology definitely gets my seal of approval. So if you need a better skincare routine, or if you don't have one at all, click the link down in the description to take the 30-second diagnostic quiz. It's free, and even if you don't go with Geology, you're gonna get a better understanding of what you need. If you do decide to try Geology, use the code TMM30 for 30% off your trial month. So that brings the price down to less than $1 a day, and I think your skin is worth it. One more time, click the link down in the description to check out Geology. So the first mistake that so many guys make is just not having a skincare routine. Even if you just wash and moisturize once per day, it's important to get into a habit. So if you're not using any skincare products right now, or if you're struggling to make it a routine, I think this is a good place to start. At a minimum, just wash your face when you shower, and then right after you get out of the shower, after you pat your face dry, use a moisturizer. If you don't shower in the morning, just kind of splash your face a few times with water, pat it dry, and then use a moisturizer. Try to do this every day for 2 weeks and combine it with other daily habits you already have, like brushing your teeth, and I promise the resistance to skincare will kind of melt away. The second big skincare mistake is giving up before you actually try different ingredients. You know, we get caught up in the brand and the price and the marketing behind these various skincare products, but really, it's the ingredients that matter. There are a handful of active ingredients that can make a huge impact on your skin, and if you don't try them, you'll never know. For example, benzoyl peroxide and salicylic acid both fight acne, but they do it in two totally different ways and they have different side effects. So if benzoyl peroxide doesn't work for you, or if you can't live with the side effects, you should try salicylic acid versus just giving up on acne fighting creams. If you've never tried a topical retinoid like retinol, I think you should. You know, for me, this class of ingredients was really a game changer, made a quick visible impact on my skin, especially as I get older. So don't just look at the bottle, don't just look at the brand, turn the bottle around, look at the ingredients, do your research. And more importantly, experiment until you find something that works for you. The third mistake is not protecting your skin from the sunlight. I'll be honest, I didn't take sun protection seriously in my teens or even most of my 20s until I moved out to Arizona for a few years. And out there, it's so sunny and it's so hot that if you don't take it seriously, you're gonna get burned and you're gonna put yourself in higher risk for skin cancer. You know, plus sunburns, they're painful, they look bad, it's not healthy, so you really have to use SPF protection on your skin every day if you're gonna be exposed to the sun for more than a few minutes. It's very easy these days because you can get SPF built into your moisturizer, so it's not like you have to put that like thick, sticky sunblock all over your face like you would at the beach. You can just use a moisturizer that doesn't feel like sunscreen, but it does have SPF built in. Really, if you could only take one thing away from this video, it's to start using an SPF moisturizer in your daily routine, usually in the morning. It's so important, and if you're not doing it, I urge you to start. The fourth mistake is being too rough with your skin. When you wash your face, there's really no need to actually scrub it. You know, even if you're using a scrub or some sort of exfoliating product, there's no need to actually really work it into your skin. You know, the product and the ingredients in it and your skin will do all the work. Your job is just to kind of apply it. Same thing when you dry your face, don't drag the towel across your face, just kind of dab it until it's mostly dry. You know, our face, the skin on our face takes a beating all day, every day for us. It's exposed to the elements. And so when we take care of it and we go through our skincare routine, it's important to just treat it gently. Another tip, when you're using any sort of eye cream or anything around that sensitive thin skin around your eyes, just kind of apply it, just dab it around your eyes. No need to actually stretch or pull your skin. Okay, and the fifth and final mistake is leaving your skincare routine at home when you're away. I know it's not always convenient to take all of your products that you use at home with you when you're on the road, but it's really important to try to stick with that routine when you travel. If you're only going away for a couple days, it's okay. But if you're going away for a week or longer, you really need to try to bring the stuff that you need to keep that habit and that skincare routine going. I recommend either buying stuff that comes in TSA friendly containers, so stuff that you can take on your carry-on bag, or buying some small TSA compliant containers and then transferring just enough of your product into these smaller containers when you travel. Personally, I usually just check a bag. You know, it's free with the credit card that I use, and that way I can take everything that I want without worrying about carry-on limitations. And especially if I'm going somewhere for like a week, like if I get away from my skincare routine and I leave the products that I need at home, I will notice the difference. I'll start to see breakouts and stuff. So I really try to maintain my habits even when I'm on the road. And this is especially true if you're going somewhere like the beach where your skin is gonna take a lot of extra abuse. All right, to wrap up, no matter what products you use, how much money you spend on them, if you go with a brand like Geology or something else, I really just wanna emphasize how important it is to treat your skin well, to take care of it, especially, you know, no matter what age you are. But if you're a younger guy, like in your 20s, start forming the habits now so you can carry them with you into your 30s, 40s, 50s, and beyond. So if you have any questions for me about skincare or anything else, leave them down below in the comments section. Thank you, as always, for watching. And until next time, stay stylish.